decided to go with Robert Redford to do the movie with him because a long relationship of trust was built up between the two. This included Redford coming out to Montana to meet him several times and go fishing with him. The script, anybody who knows the story would know that the first thing you think about in terms of making a movie of this book is that it would be a great movie, but how would you make it? And a lot of the story had to be filled out. It got filled out with real events from my father's life that we knew about, talking to him and so on, and this was relayed to Bob Redford and to Richard Friedenberg, who was a scriptwriter.
So we give Norman his problems too, the problems he really had, the real Norman had in the mid to late 1920s, of finding himself and discovering the love of his life. And mating that with Paul's decline seemed to me a perfect combination of the two brothers out of sync, one rising, one falling.
I came on after the first draft and got involved, and a lot of the stuff that I was interested in the script and providing input into was the fly fishing aspect of it. And so I worked on that part of it, and also worked on that part of it with the various fly fishing consultants we had, and sort of putting the fishing into the movie and yet not letting the fly fishing take over the movie.
Wait, everybody talk, please!
Reverend, being very Scottish, saw it as a discipline, primarily, learning to cast and learning to present the fly the correct way in the water, learning to read the water. Teaches you much more than just about how to catch fish. It's also a way to live your life. He talks about grace, and grace comes from art, and art does not come easily. That sort of maxim that he provided to his children, it sort of summed up what fly fishing served, and it was much more than just being able to go out to the Blackfoot and catch fish.
The whole idea was to try to take the book and, like I said before, put it on the screen and make it something that a universal audience can really relate to, because the problem with the book is it's very fishing oriented. You go through it and up to 60-70% of it is talking about the actual experience of fishing. And you know, the film had to go a lot more into the depths of the family and still keep the spirit of the fishing, the metaphor of the fishing.
Whenever you try to train someone how to fly fish, you never know how they'll respond. And both Brad and Craig responded so quickly, and it was almost scary. One day they'd have trouble with something, the next day they'd do it perfectly. They're very good athletes, and they listen very carefully, and they're very good at acting, mimicking what somebody else does.
He called it shadow casting, keeping his line above water long enough and low enough to make a rainbow rise. And I realized that in the time I was away, my brother had become an artist.
This one is trying not to be like a Montana picture book that you can find in every stores. Not because we don't like it, but it has been done before. It's a much more intimate story between two brothers. It's not like the goal of this film is not to bring more tourists in the rivers of Montana. And it's not telling people you should fish, but it's telling something about the relation between brothers and between members of the same family.
For me, I found the way to make the film, to see it go into a film, by treating it like a scrapbook. If you were to open a scrapbook about a piece of American history told through a very small story of a family in this place, it would have to do with time and place and character, all of which had to do with the beginnings of our country, a lot of which has been forgotten now. So in a sense, it's kind of a museum piece. So for me, looking at it as a scrapbook, as one would open a scrapbook and look at pictures of a family at a certain time in history in a certain place, and then be taken inside those pictures as you turn the pages until finally you were live within the pictures and living the story that the pictures were telling you. That was what I came to.
Fly fisherman?
There's no such thing.
There isn't?
No.
Montana, there are three things we're never late for: church, work, and fishing. Rightio.
Robert Redford is the man who brought women into fly fishing. His film came out in 1992. It had beautiful scenery, mesmerizing fly casting, and handsome men, whom I used to have all to myself.
But when I am alone in the half-light of the canyon, all existence seems to fade to a being with my soul and memories, and the sounds of the Big Blackfoot River and a four-count rhythm, and the hope that a fish will rise. Eventually, all things merge into one, and a river runs through it. The river was cut by the world's great flood and runs over rocks from the basement of time. On some of the rocks are timeless raindrops. Under the rocks are the words. And some of the words are theirs. I am haunted by waters.